My precious child, I see you with so much anger inside. This saddens me, as I am in you and I am love. Anger can be one of the most intense, destructive, and unhealthy emotions that you can experience. If not handled in the proper way, you can have drastic, life-changing consequences. This is why I left you with my word, the Bible, which was meant to be your guide through life. I also left you with my gift of the Holy Spirit, who will help you to understand my word. All you have to do is ask him. First of all, give your anger to me, and I will calm your heart, as I promised in James 1:19-20. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry, because human anger does not produce the righteousness that God desires. When you take the time before reacting to a situation and pray to me for guidance, I will bring your heart the peace only I can provide. You will then be able to move forward and resolve the problem with a calm heart, which will produce the best outcome for all. Trust me, you will be amazed how quick I work in you. Anger is a secondary emotion. Ask me to reveal the real reason for your anger. I will help you discover what it is you need to work on to resolve the real problem. Most anger comes from the feeling of not being in total control of your life. Trust in me and surrender control to me, and watch what wonderful things I will do in your life. I make this promise to you in Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plan I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Anger is also a response to the feeling of being overwhelmed or exhausted. When I walked this earth many years ago, I took much needed time just to be quiet, sit, and pray. The world tells you that you must be constantly doing something in order to be productive. You set goals and strive very hard to accomplish them. Although goal setting is important, learning to enjoy the journey of getting to your goals is even more important. Talk to me about your goals, and I will make your path straight. I will teach you how to enjoy the moment and to live in the present, which will calm your spirit and remove your anger. When life gets to be overwhelming, do what I did many years ago. Take time to sit and pray. This way, you will move forward with peace. Anger can also come from being treated unfairly or from what someone did to you. When you stay connected to me, you will not be concerned about the action of others. Find comfort in Psalm 37:7-8. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Do not fret when people succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Refrain from anger and turn from wrath. Do not fret. It leads only to evil. Get up every day and ask me how you can be a blessing to others. I will then work in you to change you from the inside out. This will be pleasing to me, and you will find great joy and happiness. I created everything for your joy and pleasure, but most days, you don't even notice my works. The beautiful sunrise that you woke up to this morning, the gentle breeze that I kiss you with, the colorful flowers everywhere, and the birds of the air flying with no care. I want you to have a full, abundant life, my child. This anger can steal the joy I have planned for you if you're not careful. My gift to you is life itself. Your gift to me is what you do with it. Life will not always be easy for you. It was never meant to be. But together, we can get through any problem. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. So, my precious child, the next time you feel anger building up inside of you, simply call my name and I will come to you, and I will turn your anger into something good. When you seek me with your whole heart and love me above anything or anyone else, there will be no room for anger in your heart, only love. I love you, my dear child, and I will never leave you alone.